Hey guys, welcome to the first part of the Green Library project, and we're going to start this project slightly differently from the other ones. For this project, the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to contribute something to our Revit file library. So right now we've accessed a lot of things from Revit City, we've got a lot of things from the Revit program itself, but we haven't actually designed a piece of furniture. I'm going to leave that in there because that's kind of funny. Or a appliance or anything like that. So we're going to design one of those first, and we're going to go through it step by step. The most important thing that I have to mention, though, before you get started is that dimensions do matter a lot. So when you're designing something in Inventor, make sure the inches match what the inches should be if the object was designed in real life. Don't just say like, oh, it looks right, but it is actually, let's say for this desk over here, it's actually 200 inches by 75 inches, because when you import it into Revit, it won't be the correct dimensions. It'll be a massive desk, and it won't fit anywhere. And then you'll ask me, Mr. Z, how do I scale a 3D object? And for those of you who have, you know, well, most of you, it's difficult to scale 3D objects the way you want, especially when there's a number of features on them. So remember, dimensions are important. Dimension it correctly. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to design a toaster, and then I'm going to walk you through the additional steps needed to make it an actual file for Revit. So let's get started. Okay, welcome back. If you're at this point, you might have just watched through the time lapse because it looked really cool and you were watching me design a toaster. But go ahead and pause the video if you haven't designed your piece of furniture or your appliance yet. Okay, so if you're moving on, I'm going to assume that you have. What we're going to want to do to whatever it is we designed is we want to change the color of the object. And typically in Inventor, we'd go over to Tools and Adjust, and we'd adjust the color. But colors don't translate from Inventor to Revit, which could cause a problem because if we try to import something that's completely colored up, it's going to show up as gray in Revit. And we actually want this to look like an actual object. So the solution to that is Revit understands material types, and we can actually change the material properties of something in Inventor. So with your object on the screen, what I would like you to do is head over to this color wheel up here, select that, and you're going to notice this is Inventor's material library. And there's a number of materials you can use to decorate your object. And they each have different looks to them, different colors to them, so you're actually able to pretty much hit whatever you'd like. Now, I understand that it might not be the exact material that you want it to be, but because we're trying to keep it simple, we're not going to adjust the material colors within the Inventor material library. That would just require creating new material types. So that's something we could do, but for this, we're just trying to match the colors as close as we can with what we're given. So I'm going to go ahead and select all the surfaces of my toaster, and for those of you who forgot, I'm holding down the shift key while clicking on the different objects. This is all my metallic section, so let's go ahead and find something metallic like. I'm going to scroll up here. We have machined aluminum. I mean, that kind of looks kind of cool, but maybe not exactly what I was looking for. This one's nice. Okay, and once you find the material you want, so this one is fine for me, there's a little like arrow. It's a little hard to see on my screen, but it says add appearance to document. And if I click on that arrow, it's going to apply that surface finish on my object. So you can see it already looks considerably cooler than how it did before. And then you just kind of want to continue that process with the other components of your appliance until you have everything. Oh, that looks cool. I'm going to use indoor pool for this one. Yeah, that looks cool. Until you have the whole thing designed the way you want. So I'm going to speed lapse this, or time lapse it, to speed this up.
You can take your pretty eyes away from me. It's not that I don't wanna stay, but every time you come too close, I move away. I wanna believe in everything that you say, 'cause it sounds so good. But if you really want me, move it slow. There's things about me you just have to know. Sometimes I run.
Now, once your materials have been applied, there's just one more thing we need to check before we actually put this into Revit, and that is over at your view cube, make sure the front of the object, when you click on it, is what you want the front to be, because the orientation is also important in Revit, and if you place it the wrong way and you import it into your home, it might be tilted 90 degrees in like the wrong way, so this could be like toppled over on the table, and no matter what I do, if you recall, you can press space in Revit and it'll rotate at 90 degrees, but it won't. You can't rotate it up vertically 90 degrees. So just remember to make sure it is on the correct orientation, which mine is. If yours isn't, all you need to do is go to the front face, right click, and then do set current view as, and then go to front, and it'll set it as the front face. And then you have this, or whatever you want to be the front of the object. Cool. This is done. What I'd like you to do is head over to the tab that is called the BIM, B-I-M. And I want you to go over to BIM Exchange. We're going to select that. We're going to get a variety of options. And what we're going to do is we're going to export building components. This is designed specifically for Revit. I'm going to click on that. It's asking that I need to save. So I go ahead and save, and then I'm going to see this option over here. We're going to convert it to a Revit file, and it's actually, we typically use .rfa, but it doesn't translate. Inventor doesn't translate well using that type. So what we're going to do is we're just going to use a .adsk type file. So I'm going to select that. If you want to give your component orientation, you see it's set to the view cube, so that's why we had to set the view cube beforehand. If you want to give your object any properties or a description, manufacturer, model, things like that, you're more than welcome to. And this will go directly into Revit's properties, so it's kind of like you're building up some of the properties. You can also give it additional features with model properties if you wanted to get really into depth with the object. So I'll just leave that on. It will just import it to Revit as well. It's just kind of picked up some arbitrary values based on the materials that I selected. Okay, I like what I see here, so I need to make sure I am saving it to where I want to. And I believe that's going to be the next screen, so I'm going to press Apply Changes, okay. And now I'm going to save this as a .adsk onto my desktop. I'm going to press Save, and right now it is converting it from an Inventor file over to a Revit file. Okay, the operation was successful, detailed animation. You can watch, or you can see the report, but the report's just going to say that it was successful. So I'm not going to see that. And everything is done. I should have the file on my desktop, so let's head over to Revit and see it in action. Okay, back in Revit, you guys might know the drill. We're gonna head over to Component, Load Family, and I'm just going to look for my folder, which I saved to the desktop, and I called it Furniture, Appliances, and Others. I'm going to double click on that, and here is my toaster. I'm going to click on my toaster, and it's going to load my toaster. And you see the little adorable picture of it, and I can press spacebar, and I can rotate the object, and I can place it down. So I'm actually going to place it to the side of this desk over here, and then I'm going to take a look in the room. I'm going to adjust my height to 4 feet so I can kind of see what's going on here. Okay. There it is. There's the toaster. And I'll flip it around. And if we switch over to a realistic view, let's go ahead, and there you can kind of see that the colors, while not perfect, they did translate over. I can select the object and I can give it a height offset, so let's give it a height offset of 3 feet. because maybe you want to stack it on the desk. You can also click on the desk, edit, and we can see the height of the desk is 2 feet and 6 inches if we just do edit type on the desk's properties. And I can adjust my toaster to be that as well. 2 feet, 6 inches, apply. Okay, so there you have it. We imported a piece of custom furniture from Inventor to Revit. So hopefully we have 18 pieces of this to work with, but that's going to conclude this video. So if you have any questions, please let me know, and I'll see you later. Bye.